Will NFTs ever become a popular mainstream product? Hi, I'm Dr. Jason Pallant. I'm a senior lecturer here at Swinburne University of Technology. I'm also a co-director of our Customer Experience and Insight Research Group. Non-fungible tokens, or NFTs as we know them, have been growing in popularity over the last few months. We've seen major celebrities buying into major collections and setting new records. We've even seen some of those celebrities launch collections of their own. We've seen marketplaces that sell NFTs record billions of dollars of transactions in the first couple of months of 2022 alone. And we've seen major brands follow this hype and launch a variety of different NFT-based collections. But even with this popularity, we've also known that only a small percentage of consumers are actually currently involved in NFTs in any form. So this is common with any kind of innovation or technology. We know that it takes time to diffuse across a population. It takes time to educate consumers about what a technology or innovation is and what value it might have to them. This is very true for NFTs in particular, where there's questions around what true value do these products actually bring beyond what we see, which is the profile pictures that a lot of people are using on their social medias. There's also some real risks and challenges to be answered around, is the technology actually secure? What real benefits does it provide? And is it even having a hidden environmental cost that a lot of consumers might not see? NFTs also have some additional challenges in an area that I research, which is around customer experience, or what we might see as CX. We talk often about barriers and facilitators to consumers' journeys when we're analyzing the CX or customer experience that a consumer has. In the NFT space, there's quite a few current barriers. And again, this is common for new technologies, but there are quite a few in the NFT space that I think are holding back a lot of consumers from actually even being able to experiment or try out what the space, what these products might actually offer them. One of those is that there's actually multiple blockchains, and this is something that we might find confusing as we hear often it talked about as the blockchain. There's actually quite a few different ones, and different blockchains have their own NFTs. Now, as a consumer, this is very confusing and complicated. And importantly, those blockchains don't talk to each other. So if you buy a NFT on one blockchain, you might not be able to use it in some other way on a different blockchain. That could be very limiting if you don't make the right choice early on. Because there's multiple blockchains, there's also multiple different currencies or cryptocurrencies. Now, the most common one is Ether, which we might have heard about based on the Ethereum blockchain, but there are actually multiple ones, and even on NFTs that are part of that Ethereum network or blockchain, there's different currencies that you can buy it in. That again is very complicated for your average consumer, particularly when you account for the fact that transferring between these different currencies can be quite challenging and actually cost quite a high transaction fee. And those fees are something that is actually quite prevalent across the NFT space. Buying cryptocurrencies, buying NFTs, transferring them, showing them off, all of these things actually cost quite high transaction fees for your average consumer. So these things are all barriers above and beyond that educational piece or learning what NFTs are and figuring out, do they even really have any benefit to consumers? Now, we are seeing some solutions and innovations arise in the space that are trying to remove some of these barriers. We've seen some new marketplaces or additional layers be built onto blockchains to make it easier. And once your money or your funds are in there, you can transact and share and show off your NFTs without any fees and within some common currencies. There's also new payment methods where you're able to buy NFTs directly with your local currency using a card, rather than needing to do all of those different transfers and picking the right currency and paying those fees along the way. Now, as more consumers look to explore NFTs and figure out whether they do really have value to them, we need to think about these CX challenges. While the technology itself has a long way to go in terms of being appealing to a mass market, we need to remember that these are people, these are consumers that have an experience when they first get into the space, and then as they think about, are they going to keep playing around or using various NFTs? So it's a really exciting space to look at, both from a technological standpoint, but also from some of those innovations for that customer experience or CX that is currently limiting many consumers from even exploring what NFTs might offer.